We are continuously improving our licensing site based on feedback from our customers. The web pages shown in this video may therefore differ from the ones you will see on the site when you log in. To complete an application, you must have a personal SIA online account. If you do not already have an account, you can register for one on our website. We strongly recommend that you check you meet our licensing criteria before you apply for a license. There is a link to the licensing criteria on the homepage of your account, on the right-hand side of the screen under the heading Before You Apply. Most frontline licenses need you to hold a particular qualification before you can apply. You should only start an application for one of those licenses when your qualification appears on the My Qualifications page. The exception to this is keyholding, which does not require you to have a qualification. A frontline license is the type of license you need if you want to work as a security guard, door supervisor, close protection operative, CCTV operator, cash and valuables in transit operative, keyholder or vehicle immobiliser. We will tell you when we receive the details of your qualification and it will show on your account. When you are ready to start the application form, select Start a New Application. This is the rectangular blue button on the right-hand side of the homepage. A pop-up will appear to ask if you will be paying for your application or if a business will be paying the application fee on your behalf. It is important that you select the correct option so the fee can be paid by the appropriate person. We then ask you to complete our diversity monitoring form, which asks questions on things like your ethnicity, religion, and gender. You can select Prefer Not to Say for each question if you wish. Fill in the diversity monitoring form and then select Save and Start Application. On the left-hand side of the page, you can see the navigation menu of the application form. This menu allows you to switch between the different sections of the form. You do not need to complete the sections in order, and you can save your progress and return to the form at a later time if you wish. You will see a tick when you have completed each section. Once you have completed each section, you need to select the blue rectangular button at the bottom right of each page. Section 1 is a pre-application checklist. Please make sure you read this, as it provides important information that will help you with your application. Section 2 is a privacy notice. It explains how we will use the information you provide to us. Make sure you read the consent statement. If you agree, select the tick box that says, "I have read and understand the above and wish to continue to make an application." You will not be able to apply for a license if you do not agree to this statement. Section 3 asks you for your personal information. We ask for details such as your name, date of birth, and nationality. We also ask for your national insurance number, if you have one. Section 4 asks you for your identity information, such as the details of your UK driving license and any passports you hold. If you do not have these documents, select No, and we will tell you which documents to provide instead. If your driving license was issued in England, Wales, or Scotland, you should only enter the first 16 digits of the number. Your driving license may have two additional numbers after the main number. If it does, do not enter these two numbers. If your driving license was issued in Northern Ireland, enter the first 8 digits of your driving license number. Section 5 asks you if you have ever been known by any other names. Examples are provided at the top of the page if you are unsure. If you have been known by any other names, select Yes, select the Add a Name button, and then fill out the form. Section 6 asks for your address history over the last 5 years. Select Add Address and fill out the form. If you are unable to provide a full 5-year address history, select the Request an Address Exception button. A pop-up will appear. Select Yes. You will then need to explain any gaps in your address history. Section 7 asks if you wish to apply for a frontline or non-frontline license. If you select Frontline, you need to select the sector or sectors you wish to apply for. Do not submit an application for a license that you do not want. If you do and we grant the license, we cannot give you a refund. Section 8 asks you for information about your criminal record. You are required to tell us about any convictions, cautions, or warnings you have received in the last 12 months. You also need to tell us if you have been charged with an offence that is currently awaiting trial, and whether you are the subject of an ongoing investigation by a public body. This section also asks you to read, and confirm that you have understood, legal statements relating to the way in which the Disclosure and Barring Service can process your criminal record check. Section 9 requires you to tell us if you have been compulsorily detained or the subject of any compulsory measure under mental health legislation in the last 5 years. An example of compulsory detention is where you have been sectioned under the Mental Health Act and you are not free to leave the hospital without being discharged by a medical professional. Examples of compulsory measures are where you have received a hospital order for a criminal offence, or have been subject to a community treatment order. If you answer yes, we then ask for your consent to contact the medical healthcare professional who treated you. We cannot proceed with your application if you do not provide this consent. Select the Add a Mental Health Record and complete the form. Section 10 is a declaration for you to confirm that the information you have provided is true and complete. Please read the declaration carefully as it is legally binding. When you are happy with your application, select the I agree tick box and then select the continue button. We ask you to review what you have told us in the application form. Please read this through carefully as you will not be able to change your answers once you submit the application. Section 6 tells you the application fee which you will need to pay. If you need to make changes to any answers on your application, select the Go Back and Edit option next to the relevant section. After you edit any section, you need to select Save and Proceed to save any changes. Then you need to complete the declaration on Section 10 again. If everything is correct, select the Submit My Application Now button. We will complete some identity checks. You may need to wait a few moments while we do this. Do not close or refresh the page whilst we do these checks. We will send a copy of your license application to the My Messages tab on your account. We then give you instructions on what to do next. These instructions will depend on the information you have given us and the results of the identity checks we have just completed. We provide a guide to the stages of your SIA license application in another video. Select the link in the video description for information on a guide to the stages of your SIA license application.